Hi, welcome to the class. Today we understand a relation between drift velocity and current. We are doing unit 2 and this is the second topic of unit 2 chapter, first chapter of unit 2, that is current relation. So drift velocity we have already done and the relation was Vt is equals to minus Pe tau upon m. Also we know that P is equals to V upon m. So Vt is equals to minus E V tau upon m. So these two are the relations or the expressions for Vt, that is the drift velocity. Now we will understand what is the relation between drift velocity and current. So I have drawn a diagram here. We have a conductor here whose length is L. And this conductor is connected to a battery, positive and negative of the battery through a key K. We all know that the electric field always starts from the positive and ends on negative. So obviously the electric field will move in this direction. All the electrons will start drifting towards the positive end of the conductor. Positive end of the conductor means this end. So that is why they are moving with Vt drift velocity. Right? There are few things which we need to understand about the few terms or few symbols which we will be using. L length of the conductor I already told you. A area of cross section of the conductor. This area of cross section of the conductor is A. Charge of an electron is E. And this is important. N, number density of electrons. What do you mean by number density of electrons? It means number of electrons per unit volume. How many electrons are there in one unit volume? One unit volume. So the number of electrons in one unit volume is N, small n. Right? Okay, guys. If A is the area of cross section of the conductor, if A is the area of the cross section of the conductor and L is the length of the conductor, then volume of this conductor will be volume of the conductor. What will be the volume of the conductor? Volume of the conductor will be A into L, area into length. If you multiply area of a substance with the length, area is 2 dimension, length is 1 dimension. 2-dimensional area multiplied by 1-dimensional distance, that is length, will become 3-dimensional volume. So this is volume of the conductor A into L. Right? Is this clear? So this is the volume of the conductor AL. Now, how many electrons are there in unit volume? So in unit volume, we have N number of electrons. So if in single volume or unit volume you have n number of electrons and total volume is this much, so therefore total number of electrons will be NaN. In single unit volume, n number of electrons, total volume is this, so total number of electrons is this. Now, charge of one electron is this much. And how many number of electrons we have? NaN. One electron has a charge E. One electron has a charge E. Total number of electrons is this much. So, total charge of the conductor. This whole conductor will have a total charge of NeAn. Clear? So this will have a total charge of this much, right? Now we all know that I is equals to Q upon T. This is the formula for current. In place of charge, can I write this? Because this is the total charge. So I is equals to N E A L upon T, right? Now this dispense upon time. This is distance upon time. Distance upon time is what? Speed. And this is what I can write as Vt. Because distance upon time. Whose distance? Total distance travelled by the electrons. That is the length of the conductor. T is the time in which the electrons are travelling this distance. So that will become the Vt. That is the drift velocity of the electron. So I is equals to NeAvt. This is the relation between current and drift velocity. Now in place of this Vt, you can write this also. So if you write this in place of dt, it will be minus n e there, it will become e square a, and then e tau upon n. So this can be another relation. If you want to put this relation in place of dt, another relation can be formed. Or if I write here in place of e, if I write e upon l, this relation can come, right? So this was the relation between drift velocity and current. So let us do few questions based on this relation. Alright, so few numericals of questions let us understand using this relation. I hope you understood this whole. So we have to go with the first question. So let us do a simple numerical. So the question reads out: estimate the average drift velocity of conduction electrons in a copper wire of cross sectional area. So cross sectional area is given 1.0 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter square. Carrying the current is given 1.5 ampere. Assume the density of conduction electrons. Density of conduction electrons is given 9 into 10 to the power 28 per meter cube. Per meter cube means unit volume, right? And they want you to calculate the drift velocity. So they want you to calculate the drift velocity. Of course, you can use the formula I is equal to NEABD. If you do it, what will be the answer? So I is equal to NEABD. Therefore, BD will be equal to I upon NEA. And of course, we know the value of E to be 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. If you solve this, it will be BD is equal to 1.5 upon 9 into 10 to the power 28 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, and then area will be 1 into 10 to the power minus 7. So this point will get cancelled with this decimal. So we have 15 by 9, which I can solve easily, and then 16 is also there. Okay, so this 16 into 9 divided by 15, that I'll solve. 10 to the power 28, 10 to the power minus 19, so minus 19 and minus 7, minus 26 and minus 26. If you solve this, it will become 10 to the power 28 minus 26, 10 to the power 2 will come. So it will be BD is equal to 15. Okay, I can solve 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 5 is a 9. So 16, 3, 48. So 5 upon 48 into 10 to the power, this is 28 and this is, it will become 10 to the power 2. Right? If you solve it, so BD is equal to 5 by 28 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter per second. Drift velocity, therefore its unit will be meter per second. And if you want me to solve this number, okay, so it will be 0.10 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter per second. So that you can easily solve, that's not an issue. You can do this division and multiplication, right? Okay, so let us do another question. So this was, have a look first of all how we are done. So this was the question. Next is the number density of free electrons in a copper is, again one more is given. So the number density of free electrons in a copper. Number density of free electrons in a copper is given. This is the number density of free electrons in a copper which is given. How long does an electron take? He is asking how long does an electron take. It means he is asking you the relaxation time. How long? Duration is asking. So how long does an electron take to drift from one end of a wire 3 meter long to its other end? Area of cross section is given, 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square, and current is of course given 3 ampere. So he is asking you to calculate the duration, that is the time in which it happens. Now I is equals to AEDI. First of all, I would like to calculate the speed, because distance I know. If I know the speed, I can easily calculate the time. Speed is equals to distance upon time, and time is equals to distance upon speed. So VD will be equal to I upon NEA. Right? So VD will be equal to 3 upon 8.5 into 10 to the power 28 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 90 dC, and then A, 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. Oh, it's like this only. Now all the values are same, I believe. Just they have changed this number. Okay. 10 to the power 8.5 10 to the power 28 into 1.6 10 to the power this, and it's correct. So you remove this point, this 30. I can cancel it out by 5 also, and I can divide them. 28 again, this will become same. I remove this point again, it will become 300. Right? So that means we can do this one. And 2 is also there. Right? So VD is equals to 300 upon 85 into 32. And then into 10 to the power 2. Because solve this, this, and this, again it will come. If you put it there, it will become 300 upon 85 into 32 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter per second. Try to solve this, what will come? So this drift velocity, my answer will be 0.11 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter per second. This would be the drift velocity. You can check this answer. 0.01, right? So check this answer, and I have the drift velocity, I have the length, and I need to calculate the tau. So speed is equal to distance upon time. I am writing tau instead of time, relaxation. So it will be distance upon speed. So tau is equal to distance as speed upon 0.011 into 10 to the power minus 2. Again, if you solve it, I am just writing the direct answer. My answer is 2.72 into 10 to the power 4 seconds. 2.72 into 10 to the power 4 seconds. This would be the relaxation time which he wanted us to calculate. So you can do these kind of questions. So this was it for today. Thank you.